Android users, I'm going to show you 8 of the coolest new Android apps that you need to try right now. So let's get started. So let's start with a new launcher that's super minimal while bringing some of the coolest features. I'm talking about the new Stadio launcher, and this is what the home screen of the launcher looks like. It's clean with the date, time, and the battery widgets. There's also a cool media player widget you can add, and at the bottom there's the search bar with the settings button on the left and the Google Assistant button on the right. Now this search bar lets you quickly launch apps and even search for things in Google. You can even swipe up to check out all of the apps listed in different categories, which is nice. The second home screen page has this nice notes widget along with the create note button at the bottom, and on the left you have your RSS feeds that you can totally customize. Yeah, this launcher looks good and you can customize things. You can set the icons to a monochrome look, you can hide apps in it, you can enable double tap to lock, and there's also icon pack support. So yeah, this is a nice minimal launcher. Now the Stadio launcher is good, but one thing where it's kind of lacking is widgets, and that's where this new app called Widget comes in, and this brings a lot of cool widgets. I mean, except for Google, nobody's taken Android widgets seriously, but this fixes that. See, this app has a ton of widgets. I mean, just look at the different options for clock. There's so many cool options to choose from. Same with calendar. There's even some really cool device info widgets. This one shows you app usage. This shows you the storage. This shows you RAM usage. And there are way more options. There are also cool options for photos widgets and music player widgets. Plus, every single widget here is totally customizable. For example, in the clock widget, you can change the clock style, the shape of the widget, colors, opacity, everything. Now those widgets are cool, but if you want lock screen widgets, the next app is for you. Look, I know a lot of Android screens have lock screen widgets, but a lot of them don't, and this app called Lock Screen Widgets aptly brings that. You can see the lock screen widget here, and you can scroll sideways to see more widgets. Pretty cool, and the best part is this lets you add any widget that's available in your phone. So you can add a widget to see the device info on your lock screen, a weather widget maybe, and more. Very useful. The widgets here are also resizable. You can change the position on the lock screen and even hide it like this. There's even a cool widget drawer available from here on the lock screen, which you can enable or disable. Moving on, the next app is for someone who uses Spotify a lot. So this is the Swipify for Spotify app that's like Tinder for Spotify, and this is super cool. I mean, Spotify's algorithm is the reason why I prefer it over, say, YouTube Music or Apple Music or anything else, and this just makes it way better. This app shows you tracks with the play button, so you can listen to the song for a bit and then decide if you want to swipe right if you like the song and swipe left if you dislike it, just like Tinder. You can keep doing this to fine-tune your Spotify suggestions, and the best thing is you don't have to wait for the songs to like you back, so no heartbreaks, and the songs you like here are synced into your Spotify library, which is very useful. Next up is an app that's specially useful for people who always forget things like their wallet, their earphones, their charger, especially when they're traveling. The app I'm talking about is the Bring Me app, and it's very simple. This lets you record the items you have along with their location. So you can add your wallet, your keys, your charger here when you're traveling. So when you're leaving, you can just check this app to see where your different items are. You can also add notes to items and even images, which can be useful for situations like when you're keeping something in your house drawer that you'll probably not check for a long time. Yeah, this is one useful app. So there are people who just prefer using voice messages instead of typing, and this app is for them. This app called Cocoon Weaver lets you save voice notes easily. You can just tap this button and start recording quick notes, but that's not the coolest part. This app even transcribes your note, and transcriptions are fairly accurate as you can see, which is very useful for when you have a quick idea or for students. You can even save these notes in different groups, search for a specific note, and all of this works offline, which is awesome. Next up is an app that makes the punch hole in your phone a little more useful. No, I'm not talking about the Touch the Notch app, which lets you open apps and do actions by touching the punch hole. I'm talking about the Noti progress bar, which is simpler. This shows you the progress of your downloads in the punch hole like this. I mean, this is very cool because this just makes tracking your downloads way easier. And this is all the customization options, but yeah, simple app, but very useful. So I know there are a lot of different apps that make the whole phone, laptop sync together better, be it Intel Unison or your phone, but this new app called Plain App brings a twist to it. See, with Plain App, you can see all your phone info via just a web link. I mean, it's easy to set up and you can see all the files, be it photos, be it videos, from your phone on your PC, even if your phone's far away. You can even sync notes here, mirror your phone screen to your laptop. This is especially useful when you need to help a friend or your parent with a problem on their phone and they're far away. I know Plain App is not the most feature-rich app out there, but it's especially useful if your phone and laptop are far away. So it's time now for the bonus app. See, not everyone knows that ChatGPT has finally arrived on Android and it's very useful. I mean, you can use it to do all of the usual ChatGPT things like asking it to write an email for you or correcting your grammar when making a post on Twitter or X or whatever it'll be called in the future. You can use it for Instagram captions. Yeah, this is all great and even supports voice now, so you can use it like a proper assistant for almost anything you need help with. Well, those are some of the coolest new Android apps that I came across, but obviously there's a lot more. So if you know an Android app that we might have missed out on, comment down below and let everyone know. And thanks for watching. See you in the next one.